Jan!
Ja, komm!
Hi, Elvis.
Hi.
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 I'm not gonna get laid, hey.
What are you trying to get laid or what? You don't even try, you don't give a shit and they crawl all over you.
Well, that's your problem, mate. You try too hard.
You piss me off. Piss me.
I'm gonna go take a piss.
You get a drink?
Same again.
Double.
No.
I'm Elvis.
I don't think so.
No, McGinnis. Elvis McGinnis.
Whatever.
And you are?
I'm Jill.
Nice to meet you, Jill.
Yeah.
Susie, what's the story with this Jill?
You mean Jack?
Excuse me.
Come on, Elvis, she's a he.
I gotta go, boss.
Oi!
Mate. Hey.
Hello.
Hello. This is my friend Jill Mayhew, Stella Kinsella.
Hi. Heard so much about you.
Really?
Yep.
Hi. We've met before.
Yes. And I'm sorry, but the name Elvis sounded like a bit of a pickup line.
It was.
So, this is where you work, eh?
Yep, this is it. Jill's gonna take me out to lunch in half an hour, if that's okay, boss.
No problem.
Do you want a coffee?
Yeah, actually, that'd be great.
We've only got instant crap. You wanna go across the road and get some real stuff?
Hey, boss's shout. I'll be back. Don't go away.
Mm-hmm. I'll miss you. So, what's a girl like me doing with a guy like Reuben? Right?
10 points for directness.
Well, he is warm and affectionate, sincere, genuine, and good in bed. Should I go on?
So, you're new in town?
No, actually, I used to live in the area, but I did the overseas thing for a few years.
And now you're back?
And now I'm back. Reuben tells me you're a cop.
Does it show?
Do I pass the interview?
So, where'd you go overseas?
London mainly. I did some work for film investments.
Movie producer?
Oh, nothing that glamorous, more like a glorified receptionist.
In London, you said? Nice. And then you came back to Australia?
Yes, last Thursday, Qantas flight into Tullamarine. Should I be writing this down for you?
the problem, mate?
Can't stay away from this place, can you, Elvis?
I first noticed him watching her in the nightclub last night.
No, I've never seen him before. I have no idea who he is.
I have no idea who he is.
You say he called out the name Mayhew, as in Jill Mayhew, like he knew her.
It seemed that way.
Yeah, he called out, "Hey, you dickhead," something like that.
Referring to Mr. Reuben Zeus?
Presumably, yes.
And you say Mr. Zeus is your...
fiancé, yes.
Reuben had just met her. He'd never seen her before.
He bashed Reuben in the face.
And then he attacked Reuben.
And then?
I followed them both out into the laneway.
And Mr. McGinnis appeared out of nowhere and tackled him.
Knocked the gun away from him and subdued him.
I don't have much experience with violence, I'm afraid.
She seemed very, very cool and in control.
I completely fell apart.
And how far away exactly were you standing from the vic when the weapon discharged?
The vic?
The victim, the deceased.
As close as you are to me?
Close enough for him to have reached out and grabbed you.
Yes.
Was that your fear, that he would grab you?
Yes, after what he did to Reuben, I was terrified.
And that's when the gun discharged.
I must have tensed up.
And you say you've had no former experience with firearms?
No.
Just want to recheck a couple of details where your statement conflicts with Miss Mayhew's version of the incident. You say the assailant called out the name Mayhew, implying that he knew her.
Yes.
Is it possible you were mistaken? He may perhaps have called out, "Hey, you," or words to that effect. I mean, the surname Mayhew sounds a lot like "Hey, you."
That's possible.
Okay. Then you disarmed him. Things exploded.
Yes.
Miss Mayhew may have spotted something you didn't. Another weapon, maybe.
Well, he was obviously intending violence. Now, the whole thing happened very quickly.
Would you characterise Miss Mayhew's actions as a case of innocent self-defence?
Given the circumstances, the fact that she was confronted by a strange male, what he did to Reuben knocking him unconscious, I would say, at the very least, she had to consider that her life was in danger.
We're still trying to contact the deceased next of kin. And pending a positive ID, there still could be a question of manslaughter.
Right.
But I am certainly not hanging out to push for the manslaughter thing. And then, McGinnis, I'm up to my eyeballs in paperwork and sicko murderers, and quite frankly, this is not on my list of priorities. Are you with me?
I'm with you, so where does that leave us?
Oh, well, Miss Mayhew's not going anywhere. And you just sit tight. We'll have another chat when I know more.
That's it then?
For now.
Mm-hmm.
So what really happened tonight, Jill?
How do you mean?
He called out your name. He said, I know who you are. Now, what did he mean by that? Who are you?
As I said, I never saw the guy before and I have no idea what this is about.
Right, came to the club last night after you did and stood in the corner, watched you. You didn't notice?
I've told you, I've never seen him before.
Right. Just out of interest then, why'd you blow him away?
Because I was scared.
You didn't look scared. You looked like you knew what you were doing.
The gun went off.
Well, not exactly. You picked it up off the ground, you took aim, and then you fired at point-blank range.
I don't recall it clearly.
Well, I do. And I haven't exactly been honest with the police about it either.
I don't know what you want from me.
The truth, Jill! Who are you and what are you doing?
Who do you think I am, Elvis? Why are you doing this? Why are you acting like such a cop?
I have information. How do I say this?
Well, just say it. Information that what?
That you are not a woman.
Well, who in the world told you that?
Someone in a position to know.
Well, it couldn't have been Reuben, not after last night. Have you asked him?
Not yet.
I don't believe this. You actually think I'm a male. You think I'm hiding something. What am I hiding, Elvis?
Look, I don't think that's entirely necessary.
Oh, come on, Elvis. How can I possibly fool a man of your experience?
Bruce?
Latecomers for an evening with the wild man. Right, stick together and follow me.
What would it cost me to get you off my back?
I couldn't sell Reuben out for money.
Then what do you want?
Would the truth be too difficult? Jill's dead, isn't she? Did you kill her?
No. I loved her. I had my operation in London when Jill and I were living together. One weekend, Jill and I went to Spain. There was a car accident.
And Jill died?
Yes. I woke up in hospital with a Spanish doctor asking me if I was Ray or Jill. They'd found our passports, but they didn't know who was who, which was which.
So as far as they were concerned, you were both female.
Jill was dead. And there was nothing I could do about that. And the doctors had obviously examined me, and I thought, there and then, that if they couldn't tell the difference, then I could simply become Jill. Valid passport, birth certificate, everything.
What about the payroll robbery?
I never meant anyone to get hurt or killed. I was just driving the car. I wanted the cash to go overseas.
To pay for your operation?
Mm. Then everything just fell apart. I didn't want to get caught with the cash, so I just dumped it and ran. Got on the first plane and went to London.
How does, Reuben fit into all of this?
I like him very much.
And if it had developed, do you think you would have told him the truth?
I suspect that wouldn't have been a very good idea, don't you? He's special.
And fragile.
I understand fragility. All I wanted was a little happiness. To be normal. To go back, pay off my debts. Do you have any idea what would happen to me in prison, Elvis? Letting me walk out with the cash.
Yes, I am. Long gone.
You prick, where's the money?
I don't know. I'd check the air conditioning ducts if I was you. My guess is they're empty.